collaboration with UNICEF and in association with EachEye is an international conference on social entrepreneurship. We are glad that the summit is also supported by the aegis of Niti Aayog, Atal Innovation Mission and Gujarat University. A special mention to our supporters, Yuva, Startup Gujarat and Industries Commissionerate. I would also like to thank our outreach partners and ecosystem partners, iHub, Young Indians, Kokarma, Startup Oasis, Global Shapers, Community Ludhiana, CIIE, IIT Hyderabad, ICOWork, SSIP, Vadwani Foundation and FRIE. Prabhav is aligned with the motive of developing a strong social startup ecosystem in the state. It will serve as a foundation to initiate dialogue, aim to have a robust support and growth system for innovations with impact internationally. I would now like to invite the CEO of AIC GUSEC, Mr. Dheeraj Bhojwani, to welcome all our chief guests for the inauguration of today's summit. Over to you, Dheeraj.
Thank you, Ashini. It's a pleasure to be here. And it's my honor to also announce that today we are completing 1 year of operations for AIC GUSEC. Last year, on the same day, we inaugurated our AIC GUSEC, which is a social enterprise incubator, despite the difficulties which were the challenges we faced due to the COVID situation. But since last 1 year, we have seen great, tremendous progress from the startups that we have received, the impact that we want to create. COVID has also invited a different sort of mindset in the entrepreneurs which we are working with and the entrepreneurs that we receive. It's my pleasure to welcome the chief guest for today's ceremony, Dr. Chintan Vaishnav, who is the Mission Director for Atal Innovation Mission. Also, we have the esteemed presence of Sri D.R. Parma, Joint Commissioner for Industries Commissionerate, Government of Gujarat. We are also in the esteemed presence of our Honorable Pro Vice Chancellor, Dr. Jagdish Bhavsarji, and also the Joint Coordinator for AIC GUSEC, Professor Rakesh Rawal. We are also joined by Ms. Moira Dava, UNICEF, and soon we are going to join by Dr. Narayan Gaonkar from UNICEF. We are also waiting for our Honorable Vice Chancellor as he walks in. Welcome, sir. We are also in the presence of our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor Dr. Himanshu Pandya. I would like to request you, Harsiti, to carry on with the proceedings for the ceremony without going a delay, because we understand Dr. Chintan Vaishnav is also running with a very tight calendar today. So over to you, Harsiti.
Thank you so much, Dheeraj. And without wasting any further minutes, I am pleased to invite our chief guest for the summit, Dr. Chintan Vaishnav, for his keynote address. Dr. Vaishnav is the Mission Director at Atal Innovation Mission and also a social technologist and engineer. To serve as the Mission Director for Atal Innovation Mission, he has taken leave from MIT.
Harsiti, may I just trouble you for a minute? We would just want to welcome Dr. Chintan Vaishnav by our Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, before we proceed with the further session. Sir, over to you.
Good morning, one and all. Dr. Chintan Vaishnav must have felt that, you know, sometimes you are ready with the fuel tank, your air pressure is perfectly okay, you are ready to speak and somebody is intervening. My sister is for being somewhat late. We are having Advocate General's audit at our university, so I was busy with them. Nevertheless, you are most welcome on the virtual platform of Gujarat University. Someday when things get normal, we would like to have you physically on the campus, because the way we are dealing with the startup and entrepreneurship in the university, being a classical university, we have conventional courses like arts, science and commerce and management faculty, but our team is working very hard. We have 4 incubators with us. They all are centrally funded. We have GUSEC, which is again a TDI. We have AIC, that is again a social enterprise by Niti Aayog, your good office. And we have Ministry of Electronics and Communication Technologies made this incubator. And recently we are awarded this MSME incubator. So we have 4 incubators with us. Besides that, we have Research Park, where we are coordinating Industry Academia collaboration. So Industry is having their R&D in our campus, and our students and scholars are working on their aspects. We do have all the defense forces on board. We have DRDO, we have Indian Army, Indian Air Force, and Indian Navy. We have signed documents with these agencies, and we are aggressively working on their requirements. I can give you a few examples. We have provided one habitat, which is right now installed at Leh, which works under minus 40, minus 50 degree temperature. So it's a wonderful initiative, what we have initiated at Gujarat University, and we would like constant encouragement and support from your good office. I have seen your biodata, and I have come across many things what you have dedicatedly suggested to the government and the system, and that's how our system has benefited a lot. So in that direction, we would like to have you on our board of this entrepreneurship journey, where we can create a pool of a knowledge which can be utilized for the better India and the new India, as per our Honorable Prime Minister's wish. Thank you very much for joining us, and I am sure that your inputs and your guidelines would be monumental in developing in our own setup and establishment as per the requirement of the society. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Vice Chancellor sir. May I now request Dr. Chintan Vaishnav, Mission Director for Atal Innovation Mission, for his keynote address to the audience, please.
Thank you very much. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. You are audible and visible both.
Okay, excellent. Fantastic. Well, it's wonderful to be in the presence of all the esteemed guests and friends in the audience. I, as Professor Pandya would remember, I have been associated with this initiative well before I came to Atal Innovation Mission. When the first time I visited your campus of where there was a plan for 4 incubators, it was essentially a building and a space identified. And we had a conversation about it. In fact, I remember sitting right next to you. So it's great to see what a long and wonderful journey this initiative is. Long meaning not in terms of time, but in terms of its accomplishments. This initiative has already taken. So I am truly honored to be with you, and very much looking forward to working with you as we move forward. Let me turn to the topic of the day. I was told that this would be a conversation about social entrepreneurship. So as Harsiddhi was describing, my background has been one of an engineer. I've often mentioned that I am a socio-technologist, somebody who is trained to understand both technological as well as human complexity in large-scale systems. I've been an academic, also an entrepreneur, both in the for-profit and not-for-profit type of initiatives, and of course now working with the government. So I will speak from, or I'll try to speak from all of these perspectives. So, of course, this question of social entrepreneurship, I mean, in my calling, for example, myself, a socio technologist, why have I added the word socio in a technologist is a question that your invitation actually made me ponder. Why did I add this word? And what is a social entrepreneur? So today, I want to first say that I think this whole category of social entrepreneurship, that category needs a lot of demystification in my mind. Because if you think about it, every enterprise at one level is having some social impact or relevance. You know, if they were not having any social relevance, then such an enterprise would possibly not exist. So then why a separate category for social entrepreneurship? That's the first question, right? So a hospital is a social enterprise that somebody has a social relevance, a doctor's office. You take any entity that you see surviving has some social relevance. So the first question is, why do we need a separate category for it? So I want to offer you three more questions, which are my questions. I'm recruiting you. I'm offering to think alongside you about these questions. And it may be that by the time I end talking today, and I will not make it very long, but by the time I end talking today, I may have raised more questions than answers. I may have created more confusion. And I think from my point of view, that would be all right. Because I think this category, as I said, needs a lot of demystification. So, okay, so let me offer you three questions. So consider these three questions for yourself, okay? First, what to you in particular, is a social enterprise? How would you define, how would you look at something and say, oh, this is a social enterprise, whereas that is not? That's the first question. Second question is, what to you changes if you were creating a social enterprise as opposed to what to you is not a social enterprise? So what changes if you were creating one? And what does not change? Right? So that's a composite question. What changes, what does not change? That's the second question. The third question is, what to you changes or should change for the ecosystem of stakeholders that are trying to nurture this category of social enterprise? Let me say that again. What to you changes or should change for the ecosystem of stakeholders who are helping nurture this category? Okay, so these three questions are my questions of the day. I'll try to offer you my answers as they stand for these questions. And once I said my answers, maybe many of you may disagree, may want to modify, may want to add, delete, whatever you want to do. That's fine. I'm not saying I have the right answers, but I think at least it'll get a conversation going between us, right? So let me say what my answers would be to such questions. Again, this is in vein of thinking alongside you. So the first question, which I said, okay, what is a social enterprise? So in my I'll give examples of my own work, just not to promote it, but just so that we can more concretely have a conversation about it. What is a social enterprise? To me, there are two situations that make an enterprise a social enterprise. The first situation is where one chooses to maximize impact as opposed to maximizing profit, right? This is not to say one should not have profit. Obviously, profit's very important. Economic sustainability, extremely important. But you are willing to make a trade-off where instead of maximizing profit, you are maximizing impact. So you're letting go of some profit for impact. That's one idea where I feel this endeavor is a social enterprise. I am not saying anything about technology, no technology, nothing. The objective, right? The second situation where I feel something is a social enterprise is where markets or institutions have failed to serve everyone equitably, and an enterprise comes in and fills this gap. That enterprise to me is a social enterprise. So where either the government or the markets failed to serve somebody, somebody else came in as an enterprise. I am not saying whether it's a for-profit or not-for-profit. I'm just saying somebody came in and said, I am going to serve this person because this person is not served the way they should be served. So that, to me, is a social enterprise. Okay, those are two answers to the first question. What is a social enterprise from my perspective? So let's take the second question. Okay, if one were creating this kind of an enterprise, what changes and what does not change as compared to what's not a social enterprise, right? Okay, so let me give you an example. You see this mask that I'm wearing, right? This has a little tag in here that says SHG95. This mask has an N95 filter inside and a cotton sleeve outside. It's washable, reusable. It has 99% bacterial filtration, but it has very high breathability and so on. Mm-hmm. So billion social mask, I'll use that as an example because that's an example of a social enterprise that I was involved in creating, and I have firsthand experience of what kind of challenges exist in creating them. So this, and by the way, I have no commercial interest in it. So just to be clear. So this came about last March, that is 2020 March, when it was sufficiently clear that this is going to be what happened in Wuhan is going to be a global pandemic. And so with four other friends, three classmates from MIT, another friend who's a material scientist, we came together and we created this platform which brought together scientists, that is mainly us, and artisans like, you know, Seva, Selco, Tata Power, CS, where many women artisans who work with many women artisans, where this platform brought them together to design this mask where an artisan designs a cotton sleeve and we supply to them from factory an N95 filter to enclose in this cotton sleeve, right? Now, the filter is NABL accredited, so it is the highest quality material that you can get. The cotton, all of that is very carefully selected and, you know, elastic, everything. This initiative, but around this, we also built a business model where we decided that we're not going to keep more than just what is what makes the factory of that provides the N95 filter viable. We won't keep more than just what it cost us and some transportation costs, and pass everything on to the artisan. So an artisan that builds a simple mask gets 2 rupees per mask. For building these masks, they get 10 rupees per mask because of the performance. This can command a premium. Also, if the artisan is willing to sell it, we give to them all of the retailer's margin also. So in the last year, as of last week, for example, this initiative has produced about 1 lakh hours of work for artisans and has supported many families, right? Okay, so what changed, what didn't change and what changed, right? That's the question we're asking. So what changed here was, see, if we didn't have the social impact perspective, we need not have built a platform that brought together scientists and artisans, right? We could have just built a factory and gone a vertically integrated initiative. So the solution design changed. What didn't change? What didn't change was the idea of providing world-class quality did not change. It has nothing, the quality and efficiency have nothing to do with whether the enterprise is social enterprise or a not social enterprise. So that's on the solution side. On the business side, what changed on the business side? Again, we could have created this such that the technology provider, I mean, the critical component of this mask is the filter. Face it. That's the only differentiator, right? This person, this factory, one could have said this factory will keep 30% of the margin, for instance. We decided not to do it. The business model was what changed, right? What didn't change? What didn't change was we still needed a viable business model. We couldn't say that just because we are trying to provide safe masks for people and livelihood to many people and all that, we won't go for a viable business model. Of course, we need a viable business model. That part didn't change. Okay, so that's the, my answer to the second question. Let's go to the third question. The third question was, what changes or should change for the ecosystem of stakeholders who are nurturing social enterprises? So let's think about that question from the perspective of the entrepreneur themselves. And I can say something from in this context, again, from this experience, for example. See, to an end user, it doesn't matter whether you are a social enterprise or not social enterprise. They need a certain product quality and, performance and so on. Some end users may say, okay, well, I'm buying this because this is a social enterprise, but that's a small portion. You still need to perform. End user does not care. The market is brutal about it, right? Second, you ask a question, what about retailers and wholesalers and all that? Again, they don't care. Today, if we want to put such a mask in a shop, they will say, I need a 30-40% margin that I take on anything else, and I'm not going to compromise it for you because you are a social enterprise, right? They don't care. For suppliers, again, nothing changes. The cotton supplier, elastic supplier, they don't really want to give you a cut because you are a social enterprise. They are doing a business themselves. For investor, things change, right? An investor is making the same choice that you are making. This is the same trade-off. Should I put my money in something where the risk and rewards are proportional and the money can grow faster? Or should I put my money in something where there is a greater impact at some cost, right? So for investors, things change. For the government, that's of course a policymaker, they should care, right? This is an institution. These are people, the social entrepreneurs, are operating in a space where the market or the governments have not been able to serve people. So a policymaker ought to care, right? Do we have the right policy environment? That's a whole separate topic. I will not go into it. But let's come back to the entrepreneur about whom we're asking this question, right? Why should these answers to these questions matter? When do they matter? I think they matter at the point where you decide which type of entity you are trying to form, right? Now there is this question of for-profit, not-for-profit, Section 8, this, that, and the other, whatever. And that question is there because, face it, today, as shown by this scholarship, most of the money in this sector is actually a charity rupee. Let me not call it charity dollar. Charity rupee, right? That's what it is. So you have to decide what kind of entity you want to call. Again, you have to make profit. There's no way around it. The only thing is whose money, what kind of money are you attracting? That's something you have to think carefully about. I'm almost at the end. And I have, I think, one more minute. So in summary, let me summarize for three questions that we were asking, right? If you're a social entrepreneur, to me, you are considering social impact at least as important as profit. You're solving a problem where markets and governments are not solving it well. You are designing both the solution and the business model to achieve these objectives, these impact objectives that you have, without really compromising any quality or rigor or financial viability and things like that, which are so fundamental to running any enterprise. And you are creating an opportunity for your customers, yourself, and your investors, which is a win-win opportunity. Then, to me, you will be a social enterprise. Okay, let me close by going back to the overarching question that do we really need a separate category for social entrepreneurship? I think my answer is yes. I would vote for yes, because as long as there are markets and institutional failures, the need for a social enterprise is not going anywhere, going away. So we need, in fact, we are on a way up. We need to do more and more of it. And we need to together, with collectively with customers, entrepreneurs, investors, government, everyone, to create that environment where there is ease of doing social entrepreneurship. That's if we can define that as a category of ease of doing social entrepreneurship. So with that, with those few thoughts, as I said, maybe I've added more to your confusion. With that, let me thank you for having me and patiently listening to my monologue. And wish you all the best for a very enriching event. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Dr. Vaishnav. Thank you so much for your time. We understand that you are running with a tight calendar. So on behalf of the university and the incubator, we thank you for your time. And looking forward for more such inputs from you in future during the interactions that we make in coming times. Thank you so much for your time, sir.
Thank you. Thanks for having
me. Namaskar.
See you soon. Yes.
Sure, sir. Harshidi, over to you for the further ceremony.
Thank you, Dheeraj. Thank you, Dr. Vaishnav, for sharing your thoughts. And I hope that today's dialogue, this summit, would initiate everybody to create dialogues even further, making social enterprises as a separate entity. Having said that, let's move forward. I would now like to invite DR Parmar, Joint Commissioner, Industries Commissionerate, for his special address to all of us. Mr. Parmar, over to you.
Thank you and a good morning, everybody. First, namaskar to Vice Chancellor, Professor Pandya. It was nice listening to Dr. Vaishnav. Most welcome to Mr. Narayan Goenkar and Mr. Dheeraj. I would like to heartily thank AIC GUSEC for partnering with the Industries Commissioner Office and the Gujarat Startup Cell for organizing this very important workshop for social enterprise startups. And you know, Gujarat is known for its entrepreneurial spirit and innovative business mindset. Before this word startup came there was a revolutionary things going on at a very early stage in the Gujarat. And the government of Gujarat has been at the forefront for working towards the development of startup ecosystem. And it has gone such a support and had a support from stakeholders also, which has helped them to gain a significant spot in the nation. And it has been recognized from last 2 years consecutively as a best performer in state startup ranking. We boast that today we have nearly 200 plus incubators supported by different policies of government of Gujarat and many thousands of young startups in the state that are working on innovative solutions for making our lives easier. And one of the key drivers for startups is the entrepreneurial passion and the overall impact. In this social enterprise, you can have both this passion and the impact. This fast-growing sector can solve social problems and exploit new market opportunities more responsibly than traditional businesses. While there is increasing awareness about this business model of social enterprise, yes, the trade-off things, which was said by Dr. Vaishnav about maximize the profit and go for maximizing impact, and social enterprise are not just making profits are not for profit-making organizations. Such innovators are very important in this ecosystem and to solve these problems of their own community at affordable cost also, to fill in the gaps also. They are doing the most effective task for improving the living standards of wider populations. The innovations are little and very simple but have an immediate and direct impact on the users. This unmet needs of our people poses a complex challenge for policymakers too. And like many challenges, it also provides an opportunity for creating communities and individuals to develop alternative approaches. And this is where such social enterprises play a very important role. It is observed that such enterprise can be transformed at a larger level, provided their participation is encouraged and that they are actively promoted in the ecosystem. Government of Gujarat as well as our incubators have also making continued efforts for training and capacity development of our startup students and handhold them such innovators, guide them and thus help us leverage the vast entrepreneurial talent. It is with this intention that in the latest scheme for support of startup under the Gujarat Industrial Policy 2020, the state government has announced an additional support of rupees 10 lakhs to startups which are creating significant social impact over and above the seed funding of rupees 30 lakhs. While the state government is supporting the ecosystem by creating supportive policies, we are very thankful to our incubators also who have helped us to successfully implement these policies on ground. This is just a beginning. I urge all of you to come forward to start having continued interactions with such pool of innovators, explore the wider available opportunities. I hope these sessions will be fruitful in generating some awareness in this direction and also help our social entrepreneurs in their capacity building and showcase their solutions to wider esteemed group. We want investors, we want accelerators to also be putting their valuable inputs to it. I urge you all to make the most of this session and we look forward to have more interactions in the future. Grand thank you and grand wishes for a successful event. Thank you.
Thanks, Mr. Pabal. Thanks for your address. And we appreciate the support that's being provided by the Industries Commissionerate and Startup Gujarat to the startups within the state. And we commit our support to the movement which is required in the social entrepreneurship space within the state. Thank you so much for your time, sir. Over to you, Asiti, once again.
Thank you, Mr. Parmar. I would now like to invite Dr. Narayan Goenka, Health Specialist, UNICEF Gujarat, India. Dr. Goenka leads UNICEF's support to the government and partners on maternal, newborn, child health and immunization programs in Gujarat. He also has co-authored many technical papers for the same. He has also received the Young Expert Presidential Appreciation Award by Indian Association of Preventive and Social Medicine in 2017. I welcome you, Dr. Narayan. Over to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Hashidi, for your nice words. Hi, good morning, everyone. Thanks to the organizers for having UNICEF in this very interesting program. I bring greetings from my office and also especially from my chief, Lakshmi Bhavani, who couldn't join because of some reason. I'm very happy to see and listen to esteemed speakers who inspire us all the time. Every time I listen to them, I get inspired. So special thanks to Dr. Chintan Vaishnav, Mission Director, Atal Innovation Mission. It was so interesting and nice to hear you, sir, this morning. Dr. Himanshu Pandya, Vice Chancellor, Gujarat University, and is also the chairperson. Actually, he's a great motivator and a team builder. Thank you, sir, for having us with you today's event. Dr. Parmar, Joint Commissioner Industries, your words of wisdom were really inspiring to many young minds, including me. Actually, we started thinking different ways how we can make progress. So first of all, hearty congratulations to entire organizing committee of Prabha, led by Atal Innovation Mission, Gujarat University, and also supported by UNICEF, your initiative. My colleague Moira Dawa is with me today to nurture all young minds and support to the extent what we can do. We at UNICEF strongly believe that children are the basis of all dimensions of sustainable development goals. And they are the, everybody, all children have the right to survive, thrive and develop to their full potential. And we know UNICEF, many of you know, we are working in the social sectors like health, nutrition, water sanitation, education, social protection, and connect very well with the social entrepreneurship, the idea, which is very much a need of the team. And I know many of us also learned a lot of lessons. This COVID pandemic has taught us many lessons, and we need to build much stronger systems and make this country more resilient. And there is a great need, hence, to nurture social entrepreneurship to bring many equity gaps, as rightly mentioned by Chintan Vaishnav sir, and also using more technology innovations, and we need winning strategies, you know, to bridge these gaps and make a progress, a sustainable progress. So, but unfortunately, you know, you see in the world, there are 1.8 billion young people in the world today, and nearly 90% of whom live in low and middle income countries, which is a very large cohort. Unfortunately, more than 2 million adolescents are out of school, and youth unemployment is, you know, 13% globally, three times than the rate for adults. You know, youth unemployment is not good for any country. So there are many different reasons for this, ranging from challenges in availability and access to good quality education systems to provide skills young people need for their employment today. So education, one of the major challenges, basically matching the training, education, basically the skill set to match to their job needs and their for life, you know. So many of the ongoing education is not really helping in skill building, which is a kind of a reflection we need to make as a country and responsible citizens, and see how we can bring more skill-based program into our curriculum. Initiatives such as Chintan Children Initiative Festival and also Hearst Start platform are good innovative program responses that blends leading approaches to youth and adolescent development, social innovation, and entrepreneurship to empower youth and adolescents, including those marginalized, both boys and girls, to become social innovators and social entrepreneurs. So these initiatives combine social innovation workshops, mentorships, incubation, and need seed funding to equip young people, both girls and boys, with the skills and resources they need to identify problems in their own communities and design solutions for them. It looks like I'm talking on behalf of our colleagues in GUSEC, but you know, we are working so long, so we are kind of part of our joint initiatives now. So while young people build social and entrepreneurship skills, these programs positively impact the wider community through indirect benefits of the products and services that young people design, as well as changing perceptions of young people as positive change agents rather than a problem to be solved. So there is a lot of energy and enthusiasm, and you know, we can bring these energies together, we can make a big change. So young people can excel in an enabling environment, and the government of Gujarat is providing a very pivotal role in shaping and nurturing the innovation and entrepreneurship in the state, which is a very big opportunity. Last time I was with the GUSEC team, where you know, even the chief minister was encouraging innovations. He said, you know, we need to solve problems but locally by creating solutions, innovations. So this is kind of, you know, the support coming from the highest level, which is really a very good opportunity, which many other states do not have. I'm very happy to know that, you know, GUSEC has now taken new steps and embarked on to the promotion of social entrepreneurship through a Prabhav initiative. I'm very happy to listen this morning. It's very, very inspiring. I'm very confident that it will play a key role in developing strong social startup ecosystem in Gujarat. It will also lay a foundation for initiating dialogue and building a robust support and growth system for innovations and impact. I would like to thank the whole GUSEC team for organizing the social entrepreneurship system, you know, this particular summit, social entrepreneurship summit. We at UNICEF remain committed to work with the government and partners to take this agenda forward and you know, make sure that, you know, the young people come forward to lead the development agenda of the Gujarat state as well as India. So thank you very much for having us, and we will be delighted to continue partnership with all of you like-minded people to push the agenda, which is good for this country, good for these children. Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you so much, Dr. Narayan, for being a part of Prabhav and helping us move forward. Now I am pleased to invite Dr. Rakesh Rawal, Joint Coordinator AIC GUSEC, for a vote of thanks. Dr. Rawal, over to you.
Namaskar. Thank you. On behalf of Gujarat University, GUSEC and AIC GUSEC, I am very much thankful to all the dignitaries and all the participants who are present in this inaugural ceremony of this summit, Prabhav. My special thanks to our keynote speaker for today, Dr. Chintan Vaishnav, Mission Director, Atal Incubation Mission. Our special guest for today, Sri Chintan Chintan Parmar sir, D.R. Parmar sir from Industry Commissioner, and our special speaker for today, Dr. Narayan from UNICEF. My special thanks to our Honorable Vice Chancellor and Group Vice Chancellor for gracing this occasion and giving a kick start to this summit. With their blessings and force, we will move forward for today's event. My thanks to Dr. Mr. Dheeraj, Rahul, Harshiddi for successfully hosting and organizing the event with the team GUSEC, AIC GUSEC, and all the partnering institutions for today. And I wish you all the best. And thank you.
Parmar Sahib, Himanshu Pandya bolu chu. Aapne jyare par anukulta hoy tyare khas padaro university. Apni sathe thodi baisine charcha kare.
Sure. I will be glad.
I would request Mr. Narayan Goelkar or Goenkar. You can unmute
Narayan yourself. Yes.
So you are also welcome at Gujarat University campus. We are regularly meeting, but let's meet for this particular Prabhav series. We'll make it sure that it should be a series of events. Every year we can have different speakers from different fields, artisans, we can call everyone. It's a wonderful nomenclature, Prabhav. And we need to create some Prabhav impact on the social enterprises, where we can make changes to the lives of the common. Thank you.
Together we can make it. Thank you so much.
Sure.
I thank everyone for the presence. Over to university for the ceremony.
Thank you so much. Thank you everyone for being present with us. I would now like to invite Mr. Jatin Chaudhary, founder of EachEye Network, a network that has grown to be one of the biggest startup ecosystems of Gujarat, with physical presence at 25 plus global startup cities in 15 countries. Over to you, Jatin. Thank you. Jatin, can you hear us?